Are we ready for our evening of entertainment tonight? I'm wandering the crowd. I would have used my teacher voice, but I figured it's just too big. But I did want to start the evening with just a couple notes to begin. And the first thing I would have said, you heard the minister talk today. And by the way, my name's Chris McPhee. I'm the superintendent of Canadian Rockies Public Schools here in Canmore and Banff. Our minister mentioned the Iron Goat is a place that he hangs out when he comes into town here. Well, I have to say that as a superintendent and assistant superintendents, we get home late at night sometimes. And many times I end up down at the corner of the bar there having a meal or a glass of wine. In fact, I think there's times that they affectionately refer to me as Norm from Cheers. And it made me think if the minister was still here, but Mr. Casey is our MLA. And I was going to talk, well, we know this, the budget, and we hear about oil and all of these pieces. And it brought me back to a time where I thought of my favorite clip from Cheers, where Norm comes in and Sam says to Norm, "How you doing, Norm?" He said, "Pretty good, Sammy, but it's a dog-eat-dog world out there, and I'm wearing milk-bone underwear." That's kind of how I'm feeling right now. So, and just on another note, last night, obviously, Lyndon McIntyre, who was fantastic, and a hometown boy from Cape Breton. Woohoo! How many Maritimers in here? How many Atlantic Canadians in here? Now, does anybody know the difference? Atlantic Canada includes Newfoundland, the Maritimes doesn't. So you know. Now, my father once told me a story. He said there's a reason why all the Atlantic Canadians are coming out to Alberta. He said, it's because we finished our work at home and now it's time to come out and help you guys. So, without further ado with this, I want to introduce your entertainment tonight that I'm very proud to do and nervous for them. But it's our students from Canmore Collegiate High School here in town. And we have the band for Canmore Collegiate that's here. As well, one of our international students from Japan, Mika Hirata, has joined them. And Mika's going to start by playing the first few numbers before the band. But just as we begin, I think I'll turn it over all the way from New Glasgow, Nova Scotia, their teacher, Miss Susan Garrier. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, next up, the Canmore Collegiate Jazz Band. So we're gonna turn it up a notch here. So just bear with me for a moment. We're just gonna do a couple tuning notes and then we're gonna get started. There we go. Okay, so the first song that we are going to be playing tonight is called Green Onions. It was originally recorded in 1962 by Booker T and the MGs. So this song incorporates the 12-bar blues, so I want you to listen for that, see if you can detect it in this song. We have two soloists tonight, Ben Cook and Clayton Lillis, both on the alto sax, so enjoy. No, there we go. Okay, next song, we have Watch What Happens. This song is a bossa nova tune, which literally translates into new trend. So it's a Brazilian jazz piece, which was popular in the 50s and 60s, this bossa nova. So Hope you enjoy it. We have Jenna Krausert on the trumpet, our soloist tonight. Next up, we have a song called Cantaloupe Island by Herbie Hancock. Has anybody heard of Herbie Hancock? Yes, many people. Good. This was originally recorded in 64. When I originally heard this song, it was actually in 1993 when there was a band called Us Three that covered it. And they are a jazz rap group from California. So I hope you enjoy it. Clayton Lewis again on alto sax, Ben Cook again on alto sax, and Lucas Chartrand on percussion drums. They're brave souls soloing like that, hey? Awesome. Next song is called What Is Hip? It's by Tower of Power. So they were around in the 70s again. American R&B band that played a lot of funk, soul, and jazz. And tonight we have Carl Stoliker soloing on the trumpet. So. So this is our final piece for the evening, and it's called Pick Up the Pieces. Anyone know this one? I thought you might say that. By Average White Band. This one peaked number 5 on the soul charts in 75 and number 11 on the disco charts. I thought that was quite interesting. So tonight, we are going to feature Clayton Lewis. Thank you very much for your attention tonight.
Isn't this rural education at its finest? You know, it's a night like tonight and listening to these folks that make me say I'm proud to work for you. And it's been fantastic. Thank you so much. And on behalf of the group here, we can't thank you enough, and we have a little gift for you at the end. But again, can I have another round of applause for these guys? Thank you. Thank you. And one more, Mika, come on out one more time. And Mika Harada. Thank you. Thank you. Thanks, everyone. Do a replay. Do a replay. Come on. Absolutely. The last one. There you go. Which one?
The first one.
The first one, someone's saying back. Now I've been told to tell you folks there's drinks next door, so you're all ready to go? That's the directions from Mr. Andrea.
The third annual Alberta Rural Education Symposium Committee would like to take a moment to thank our key sponsors. Synovus Energy, applying fresh progressive thinking to minimize the impact on the environment while safely producing energy resources to meet world needs. Alberta Education, a proud supporter of the Alberta Rural Education Symposium for the past 3 years. Dreamstock Studios, websites made beautifully simple. Maintaining a great website shouldn't be a chore. And the Canmore Coast Hotel and Conference Center. Perfectly suited for your special event, the Coast features 10 meeting rooms with space for groups up to 600 people.